Damn, the power is out. It's impossible to develop that roll of film now. At least now I finally have the keys to my old room. But why was it locked in the first place? Finally, I can enter my room. It's like being a child all over again. I used to play with the puppets by reenacting what was happening in my life, to clear my mind. I want to do it again. At the beginning of any puppet act, there was always the legend of the White Lady. Otherwise, the scenes I was reenacting were worthless. According to an ancient legend, the lakes of the area are haunted by the spirit of a young woman who was killed by the man she loved. A lover's nightly tryst by the lake. So much hope and desire, but death, not love, was awaiting her.
What a beautiful moon tonight! My love is not here yet. I'll wait. You're here at last! Going on? Why are you acting weird?
You cheated on me!
Are you crazy?
Are you crazy?
Langsung dibunuh, cok.
I love you too much. The thought of you with another drives me insane. That's why you have to die. What did I do to you?
Kasihan dia.
In despair, the man confessed he had killed her out of jealousy. They searched everywhere, but the girl's body was never found. Since then, her spirit, known as the White Lady, takes the life of a young woman whenever events take her back to that sad day. Now I can begin. First of all, let's clarify what happened the night before the cursed 16th of July.
Dad says we're losing. What will happen if we do?
They will take everything from us.
Will we go to Germany?
Did you see Lapo yesterday?
Why do you ask?
I saw him leave the barn. Weren't you there? want to come with me to the lake tomorrow? I want to bathe. I want to take some photos. Let's go at dawn. Mummy sleeps heavily anyway. You know she's been taking that medicine. Wake me up!
Shall we swap beds like we used to when we were kids? Sure.
Sure, great idea. Yes, it happened like this. Then in the morning, Martha went to the lake pretending to be me to show her pregnancy. She knew Mother was going to follow her down. Now I can only guess what happened when they met at the lake.
You are pregnant. Your sister was right. This definitely didn't happen. Martha had a scar on her forehead. How did she get that?
Thank you.
you are pregnant. Your sister was right.
What do you want from me?
How dare you talk to me like that? Well, at least I had fun. I'll punish you for this, whore. Try! I dare you!
Dung! 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 Dung!
This might be exactly what happened. Hello, Mummy.
Julia.
Hi, Julia.
What do you want from me?
What do you want from me?
Take off your clothes. I want to see your shame.
No way!
I'll take that dress off for you, stupid girl.
I'm going to kill you!
You're insane.
You're insane! You are insane! Do you realize that? Do you want to hurt me, Mummy? Yes, this version is credible.
Sorry.
are pregnant. Your sister was right.
What do you want from me?
How dare you talk to me like that?
Well, at least I had fun.
I'll punish you for this, whore. Try. I dare you.
Dung. 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 Dung.
This might be exactly what happened. I will never know exactly what happened, but I think I have an idea. And after everything, I shot my mother. No, I didn't shoot. What actually happened? It is all in my mind, but I can remember. I know I can. A little arm. A small leg. And another little arm. Another small leg. Oh, look, only the head is left. I was under the bridge, but it was just a game. This, however, is not a game. I was just playing. It's just a bad joke. Under the bridge, the church, town, speak, the white lady.
Di sini. Oke, ya. Dane.
I mustn't care about what people think. Fear will prevent me from facing the music. It will be very difficult to recover from the mental collapse. Destiny is inevitable. The end waits for us. The power is back. Now I can develop the role and hopefully have my questions answered. Lorenzini haberdashery, 5 meters of grey cotton fabric, 6 meters of white linen fabric, 4 meters of green satin, delivered on June 5th, 1944. In the event of an issue, contact us on the number 6987. And this red fabric? It's not been mentioned. Could this also be one of Mummy's, or could the nanny have left it here? I will return to you, Martha. Together we will sort out everything. Just you and I.
I'm going to go to the studio. The studio, sama. Mama, 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 mama aku.
Oh dear God, so it's true. I killed my sister. I did everything to hide the truth. Then I killed my mother to rid myself of the guilt. But she was nasty and everything was her fault. God, what does that make me? I don't deserve to live a second longer. Maybe I will see her again and I can try and ask for her forgiveness. But if there is nothing after death, at least I will be free from this suffering. I know it's not right, but I can't do this anymore. I fired instinctively at that soldier, hitting him right in the head, but it was not a good idea. He obviously didn't come alone. When the others came in, I closed my eyes. I heard a lot of commotion and then felt a sharp pain in the stomach. They were kicking me while another tried in vain to convince himself that the soldier on the ground was still alive. They hit me in the ribs, the back, and the stomach. I couldn't breathe, and at the same time I felt the need to vomit. They were ordered to put me on a seat. They bound me up so tightly that I couldn't feel my hands or feet. On the seat next to me was my father. He was breathing, but he appeared to be unconscious. The guy in charge started asking me questions. He kept hitting me in the face and head with some kind of short cane. It was so violent I thought my skull would crack open. All I could taste in my mouth was blood and broken teeth. I ran my tongue across my teeth, thinking to myself that I'd never be able to smile again. A frivolous thought, perhaps, but a painful one nonetheless. Part of my top lip was cut open and was hanging down. I foolishly tried to put it back in place using my tongue and lower lip. I threw up. They forced me to confess that my father had been carrying out all kinds of activity within the German army. Of course, I didn't know anything about it, so I tried to explain. But those punches. I would have done whatever it took to stop them. Whatever it took. Just after I told them what they wanted to hear, the general said, "All it took were two slaps and you sold out your father, you German whore." Then he ordered my father to be executed. It took less than a moment. He didn't even move. He pointed to one of the soldiers and then he pointed to me. My time had come. They all left except for the soldier who had the unpleasant task of finishing me off. I wanted to die, but not like that.
terror engulfed me. I could almost hear the sound of my body evacuating. I had the gun pointed to my forehead. I couldn't look at his face. I stank. I felt indecent. Then he moved the gun on purpose and shot without hitting me. He had taken pity on me. It must have been my fate not to die. He quickly cut the ropes and pushed me to the ground, saying out loud, "It's done. The German whore has been dealt with." I was left motionless on the ground. He left, and I fainted again. When I came around, I did not know what to do. I was completely empty and felt pain everywhere. Everyone was dead. I was now alone in the world. I felt a desire to hear their voices one last time on Daddy's recorder in the dark room. Provided the soldiers hadn't destroyed it, that is.
Now I will wake her up and she will confess. You can bet on it.
What are you doing with your father's gun? It's dangerous. Stop it. Talk. Tell me everything now. Tell me what you have done. Okay, okay. Calm down. I will tell you everything. I found that strange note when I woke up, and I immediately realized that something was wrong. Something was up with you, aside from your usual quirks. I came to check, but you weren't in your bedroom. You had spoken about the lake, and I got worried, so I called your father, and we went to see what was going on. We found you sitting in your underwear at the side of the lake. You kept saying that nothing had happened, and you kept repeating things like that. I hugged you to try and make you feel better, but you did not speak again for days. What is happening to you?
You should tell me what's going on. I'm not going to that loony bin.
I would never have wanted this, but I'm afraid you will harm yourself further. You were really hurting yourself in front of the piano that night. What else could we do?
You killed my sister and now you're afraid because I found out. So you're making up stories, aren't you? But I'm not falling for it this time.
What are you saying? Your sister. Please, no. I was not well. I didn't know what I was saying. So many years have passed. You were little then. I thought everyone had forgotten that nonsense.
Shut up. Don't speak. Don't say anything else.
What are you doing, my daughter? Why do you want to ruin your life?
I'm sorry. It wasn't me who just shot Mummy. It wasn't me.
I didn't know who I was anymore. Everything had fallen apart. I was afraid of myself. My God, it was terrible. I had always been convinced that I was too good for myself, but then I had become my own enemy. I was the danger. What should I have done? I thought about the puppet theater in my old room. There I could find something in myself, perhaps. So I rushed to go play with it again.
Komunikasi kabel ini kan? Thank you.
print should be fine like this. You can see detail clearly.
Fotonya udah string. Udah telat belum sih? Siapa foto?
To go far away from here, I need to have a good reason. To go far away from here, I need to have a good reason.
What happened here? Apa tuh Yobel Buana? Mati ya, masih hidup teleponnya kan? 938.
Maybe later. Mummy nearly died giving birth to me. This is what remains in my memory of my mother's, nanny's, and father's stories. I remember little to nothing of my childhood at home. I have to try, though. Maybe the important events I should know are right there.
How are you, madam? I feel a sharp pain. Do you need anything? I can feel it. The time has come. Everything is ready. Help! Something is wrong. Erik, help! Irene is not well.
How are you, honey?
I'm getting weaker and weaker. Doctor, hurry! Irene is sick! Don't worry, Irene. The pain you feel is natural.
Push.
Push, Irene, push. Push, Irene, push. Push, Irene, push. Push, Irene, push. Push, Irene, push. The baby is born. I feel sick. I feel myself wasting away.
It's going to be okay.
Poor mummy. She has suffered so much. I have hurt her so much ever since I was born.
Mummy, I'm hungry. No, it's not meal time, you little nuisance. Mummy, I'm thirsty. You just had a drink, whiner. Mummy, I have to pee.
And what can I do about that?
And what can I do about that?
First, command me.
Mummy, I'm sleepy.
That's enough to cook.
That's enough! Go to your room! Get out of my sight! I can stand you no longer! How dare you! I will make you pay for that! My hands are not enough! You need to learn properly this time!
Sorry! It was an accident, Mummy! Please don't hit me! Sorry, it was an accident, Mummy. Please don't hit me.
Dumb.
This is just a game. Is it only a game? I believe the White Lady said that my lost memories would return in the place of my happy childhood. This is the only place I have ever been truly happy. Are these my memories then? Is this actually my life?
Sister, Julia, play with your sister.
What's up? Did Julia make you cry? Don't cry, my love. You know Mummy loves you. Stop making up these stories! Julia, play with your sister. Martha, don't you want to play with your sister? I love you, Mummy. Now go play with your sister. Can we play patty cake?
particular. The upper top.
What are you doing? Are you crazy?
It's all Martha's fault.
It's all Martha's fault.
I don't believe you. I saw that. You think you're so smart. You're too good, Martha. It's not your fault. I've seen it all. That's not... Liar, liar! Liar? To whom? Now let's see what happens to you. Come with me now.
Sorry, Mummy. I'm so sorry.
Come with me. I will put you in your place, girl.
Sorry, Mummy. I won't do it anymore. I promise.
Too late. These false tears won't help you. Stay still. Now I'll make you want to bark.
Leave my dog alone.
There's no point screaming, stupid girl.
No, Mummy, please. You're insane.
Sure.
Now I'll show you how insane I am.
Help, Daddy, help.
Screaming won't work. Your father is not here, like usual. Eat it!
No!
Eat!
I won't eat him!
I said eat!
I was beginning to remember. but I was so scared to remember too much, especially all at once. I didn't have time to guess exactly what happened. It was making me too upset. Pulling out those memories was like trying to pull out a tooth on your own. Almost impossible, and far too painful. The White Lady told me that the church is a safe place and home to its children. Don Attilio, my priest, I have to talk to him. I have to call him on the telephone.
Don Attilio speaking. Who is it?
Father, help me. They're all dead. Daddy, Mummy, everyone.
Julia, come to me immediately. Don't stay alone. It's dangerous. Come to town. You can stay here with me and we can talk about everything. Okay?
Okay, Father. But first I want to play with my puppets for a while.
Julia, don't be silly. Come to church right away.
Wah, jauh banget bro. Sepeda gue bro.
I can't go to San Casciano on foot. It's too far. I can't go to San Casciano on foot. It's too far. I can't go to San Casciano on foot. It's too far. I can't go to San Casciano on foot. It's too far. I can't go to San Casciano on foot. It's too far.
The bike was in the same way.
There we go. The photo is where they requested.